Hey YouTube, it smells like Vin here, and I have not done an album review in a very long time, and I'd like to do one now. So I haven't been uploading a lot of videos lately. I've had a lot of stuff going on, and also I just kind of haven't been in the mood. But I'd like to ask you guys something real quick before I go on with the review, because we have a really interesting album. Would you guys help me, and share my videos around? And I'm not the type of person who's always asking for, like, share my videos, you know. But I've come to the conclusion that I'm getting subscribers relatively slow. Sorry, this piece of hair is annoying me. And it would, you know, that's one of the things that sort of makes me a little discouraged from doing videos, is I just don't feel like I'm getting that much feedback and views, and I'd really like a lot more subscribers than I have. So if you guys like my videos, feel free, obviously, to share them. I'd appreciate it. And if you make videos and you do share mine, let me know so I can share yours. Kind of like a you scratch my back, I scratch yours sort of thing. And, yeah. And second thing, would you be interested in videos that are not about music? Because, you know, I've always wanted YouTube to be, like, my outlet for things. And I haven't really used that to its full potential. You know, I've just talked a lot about music, and I love music. It's my favorite thing ever. So that's obviously why I talk about it. But would you guys be interested in some other topics that I think you find interesting? And I don't mean video games or movies or anything. I mean, like, discussions about life and about emotions and feelings and the mind and about spirituality and things like that, because I really want to start talking about that stuff. And hopefully you guys might be interested in some of that stuff. Because, you know, you guys don't really know me, and I'd like to maybe try to give some more personal stuff, but not too personal, obviously. But I wasted about 2.5 minutes, so give me feedback on all those topics down below. And let's enter Jurassic Shift by Ozric Tentacles. It's either Ozric Tentacles or Ozric Tentacles. I'm just going to say Ozric because it sounds cool. And this is a mind-blowing band. Mind-blowing band. No other way to say it. No other way to talk about it. These guys are a space rock, prog rock, jam band, whatever, that got together in the late 80s, I believe, and I believe are still going. I'm not too sure about that, but I think so. And their sound is none other than mind-blowing, a completely and utterly mind-blowing. You get, it's instrumental, all instrumental, except one little vocal passage in the sound, but it's just kind of a weird, indistinguishable voice, and then it kind of segues into another section of a song. The third track, Feng Shui, I believe it's titled. Weird song names. But these guys are in an all-instrumental band that favors trippy, spacey synths, as you can hear, fantastic hints and elements of techno and electronica, really, really psychedelic space rock elements, jazz fusion elements, a lot of jazz influences, actually, improvised soloing, interesting time structures, long jam-based songs. And it all culminates into this 50-minute journey that is Jurassic Shift. And the cool thing about these guys is that they know how to keep you engaged in this kind of whirlwind of just synths and interesting drumming and extremely, extremely groove-laden rhythm section. The bass and drums on this record are extremely audible, and you can always hear them, and I'll go into that more in the production. But another thing I like about this record is the variety. who get everything from really spacey cosmic rock, like this song here, which is called Sun Hair. I'll give you guys a little listen really quick. Really, really spacey synths everywhere. Just kind of this whirlwind of note, of sound. Really, really crisp drums. And fantastic guitar playing as well. So, it's absolutely fantastic. Two Middle Eastern influence tracks, like Half Light and Thethyli, and Feng Shui, which are more Japanese influenced as well. You get really, really just mind trips, like the title track, which may take the cake for my favorite song off this record. And then maybe a little bit of more heavier stuff on the harder rock side, like Vita Voom, which is the closing track and the conclusion of this record. The production is absolutely fantastic. Everything is so crisp and clean, and because there's so much things going on in the record, and it just takes you places, you need to hear everything that's going on, and the crisp, clean, precise production just exemplifies that feeling of the record, and just makes it fantastic. The flow is also great. Each song is different while containing similarities to each other track, so they're all one, but they have differences in them. Like I said, the whole album just sounds like this one big journey, because it just sounds like one jam session, and it the music is just so deep and so detailed that if you just sit down and give yourself completely to it, I've had the experience of listening to this record and sort of half dreaming while I was still awake listening to it. It puts you in like this unbelievable, somber, relaxing, kind of out of body experience, this record. So, I love the gong. So, it's absolutely fantastic. It plays with your mind, this record, and it is the, in my mind, the exact definition of what psychedelia is all about. And here we hear another Middle Eastern influence section, so I'll let you guys hear this. Sick bomb, bongo work, awesome syncopation, like it kind of builds up and builds up and builds up and goes back down and builds up and goes back down. The song length, so another thing I like about this record, some of them range to like 4 minutes, not that many of them, and then others range to like 11 and 10 minutes. So, yeah, damn, this record is amazing. It was released 1993, and it is fantastic. There's some flute work on here. There's just tons of textures and sounds and instrumentation that gives the record variety without sounding too discombobulated. They all work together to create what is Ozric Tentacles, you know? And it's a sick record. It's an amazing record. It's mind-blowing. I just love it. I just get lost every time I listen to it. And isn't that what you want for music, for the most part? So, if you want to take a trip, whether you're using drugs or not, Ozric Tentacles, Jurassic Shift, I'm gonna have to give this record like a 10, really. There's really nothing I don't like about it. It really is a close to being absolutely perfect album. In fact, I really can't think of anything I don't like about it. Yeah, it's just really, really great. Nice album cover too. So, Ozric Tentacles, I'm back. I'm gonna start doing a lot more reviews because I miss it. And like the questions I said in the beginning, would you be cool? I mean, not that I'm not saying I don't care about your opinion, but I'm not asking for permission. I'm just asking if you guys would be interested in it. Different topics I'd like to start to get into, and you know, discussions with you guys, and if you guys should, you know, could share some of my videos, and just make the Smells Like Vince channel a lot bigger. So, my name is Vincent. I'd like to thank you guys all for watching and coming back time and time again to hear what I have to say about some of my favorite records. What do you think about this album if you've heard it? And yeah, thanks. I'll see you guys next time. You guys are awesome.